So welcome back again. Today this may be the last class on cyclic classification of subgroups of a cyclic group. So in the last lecture we have discussed basically the fundamental theorem of cyclic group, and the theorem says that every subgroup of cyclic group is cyclic. And then we came to know that what are the generators, and what is the form of generator of a cyclic group. Okay, so this was the theorem we proved yesterday, and of course this was one of the most important result of cyclic group. It combines three different results. Of course they are dependent on each other, fine. So we will be having several application of this theorem in coming lectures. Okay, so as application of this is one of the important application of this is on when we are going to talk about the group of integer modulo n under addition. Okay, under addition modulo n. So for on this group we can see application, and which is really interesting. So thing is that if G is a group, it says three result. If H is a subgroup of G, so this would imply that H is cyclic. Okay, if H is cyclic, G is cyclic. Or we can say like this, that I'm just keeping it in different in three statements, so that you can understand this one. So if G is cyclic and H is a subgroup, H is any subgroup of G, then H is cyclic. Okay. Then the second result is that if order of the group generated by A, of course any element of order n generate a cyclic group of the same order. You know, it means that the order of A, the group generated by order of A is going to be n, and this is the same order will be of A. Okay, so if it is so, then the order of any subgroup A is a divisor of n. Okay, then if H is a subgroup of A, the group generated by A, okay, then if this, then or we can write like this, and I can use here, and H is a subgroup of, then the order of subgroup that is H divides N. Okay, and then the third part is, this talks about the generator. Okay, in fact this talks about the generator for each positive divisors of K of N. So let order of A is equals to n, and K is any divisor, in fact positive, fine, positive divisor of n, then A has exactly one subgroup of order K, fine, and this subgroup is nothing but this subgroup is given by A to the power, the group generated by A raised to power n by K, fine. So all we need to know that we should have a group which is cyclic, then we can very much say that that group is it's all subgroups are cyclic, and in this case, of course, they are not telling that the group is cyclic. Of course, if the group is cyclic, then there should be some element which generates A, and then the order of these two will be same. Okay, so they are talking about some element. Okay, so if this element generates G, then all right, there is no problem. It means that the group is cyclic. So this the second result is also applicable for any cyclic group also. Fine. And then the third one is that if N has order N, A has order N, and K is any divisor, then corresponding to that divisor, we are going to have exactly one subgroup of the group generated by A. Fine. And that of order K, and that subgroup is generated by this element of this form. Okay. So let us see. So all we need to have a generator. You know, this group is generated by which element? A. So let us see the corollary to this theorem on the group Zn. Fine. We know that Zn is generated by 1. Fine. Zn is generated by 1. It means that you know Zn is cyclic also, all right. Then all its subgroups are cyclic. Fine, according to the first result, this result, all its subgroup will be cyclic. And then in the second result implication here says that if N has a some element A has order N, fine, and if you can find some subgroup of that one, then the order of each subgroup will divide N. Fine. And the third one talks about the generator. So how generator we are getting? The generator of this, that is A, raised to power N by K, where K is divisor of N. Okay. So one is generator of Zn. So its subgroup will be given by like this. Fine. But since this is additive group, so we should write N by K times 1. Fine. You know, N times A. Fine. A mein agar hum baat karein ki A kisko generate kare, agar group additive hai, isme elements kaise honge? N times A honge, jahan pe N belong kar raha hoga set of integers mein. Fine. So ye ho jayega hamara. Okay. N by K times N is type ke isme elements होंगे. Okay, so essentially this is going to be N by K. Fine. So ये इसके subgroup generate करने जा रहे हैं. Okay, so for instance, one example we can take. So इसमें इस corollary में यही है कि then the set N by K is the unique subgroup of Zn of order K. Fine. ये अब N by K को आप सपोज n टाइम्स ऐड कर रहे हो एंड दिस शुड बी n. सो व्हाट शुड बी द वैल्यू ऑफ m, सो दैट आई एम जस्ट टॉकिंग अबाउट द ऑर्डर ऑफ दिस वन इन Zn. m सर्टेनली नीड मस्ट बी k, m इक्वल्स टू k, सो दैट दिस टू गेट कैंसिल एंड वी आर हैविंग n ओनली. फाइन. So this is what they are telling in this theorem, in this corollary. Okay. So for example, let us take Z30. You can take other examples too. So what are the divisor of 30? What we need? We need divisors. Okay. So we are in fact going to list out all subgroups of Z30. So divisors of Z30, we can write. Divisors of 30, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, 15, and 30. They are positive divisors of 30. Okay. So we have K here. Then the subgroups are given by or generated by 30 by K. Okay. So for each value of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to 30, we will be having a subgroup of Z30, fine? So when we are keeping, when we are giving value k equals to 30, k equals to 30, so we will be getting here the group generated by 30 by 30, fine? And this is equals to 1. Hello. Yes, sir. And then we are going to get here 30 by then we are having 15. We are going to get to here. Fine. And then 30 divided by 3, we are going to have this one, I think. 15, this one. We are going to have this one. Okay. So, like this. And then Z30 divided by 6, we are going to have 5, fine, this one. So similarly, we will be having these subgroups, fine. So in fact, this one is nothing but essentially same Z30, and it has order 30. The ordered 30 means that the number of elements in that group, fine. Of course, in 30, when we are going to take k equals to 1, so in case k equals to 1, we have z 30 divided by 1. We have 30 divided by 1. Sorry. We have 30 divided by 1, and this is going to give us 30. So 30 is essentially equals to 0, fine. So for each value, each divisor, we have here some unique subgroup, fine. So I think this is clear. But beyond this, let us discuss something more. But we will be discussing after this result, okay. So thing is that there are so many elements here. Here 30 elements are there, here 15 elements, 10 elements, 6 elements, and 5 elements, 3, 2, and 1 element. Okay. In each subgroup. Fine. How many proper subgroups are there? We have at least 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 are proper and 2 are improper. One is trivial. This one is trivial, and this is Z30 itself, fine. So let us analyze more. To analyze more, how many elements in each group or subgroup of which order? You know, until now we know that okay, in this group we have 30 elements, we have 15 elements, we have 10 elements. Okay. So next theorem will tell us, will give us a way to determine that how many elements are in a group of a particular order, fine, okay. Just like here, if you see that this has order 1 and this has order 1, 0 has order 1 and then 15 has order 2, fine. And here 10 has order 3 and 20 has order 3. They are inverse of each other, okay. Similarly, 6 has order 5. And 12, I guess 5 itself, okay, I think 5, okay. So similarly, this will be analyzed. And let me see, if you are able, if you are asked, okay, you just to find out what will be the subgroups, what are the subgroups of Z15? So we need to have divisors of 15. So divisors of 1 and 2, not 2, 1 and 3, and then 5, 1 and 3, 5, and then we have 15, I guess this much, okay. Hello, and then subgroups. subgroups and their order. Okay. So subgroups, this subgroups iske kaun se honge? 15 divided by k, and k will be having value, will be taken value 1, 3, 5 and 15. So once we are taking k equals to 1, then we are going to have 15. Okay. And this 15 is nothing but 0. Okay. And then we are having 15 by 3, that is 5. And then 15 by 5, we are going to have 3, and then 15. So in case of 15, we are going to have 1. Okay. So these are this is nothing but this is Z15. Okay. So in 15, how many elements in this? How many elements? So we need to have we can write here. Okay. If we observe here. In this set especially, so they are all multiple of 10, fine. Here all multiple of 15, and these 15 these elements are from 0 to 29. You know Z30 is equals to 0, 1, 2 up to 29. So among these they are counting here multiple of 10, here multiple of 6, multiple of 5, multiple of 3, multiple of 2, multiple of 1, fine, among these. Okay, so it means that if this is the generator, okay, so n is something or k is something doing playing some role here, fine, k is playing some role here. Okay. So in fact, these subgroups are of the form Zn, something like this, of this form, in fact. Okay. So we will see that in fact, all subgroups of Zn are of the form n times of Zn. Of course, when we multiply this with some natural number, they are going to be in that one only, in that set Zn only. Fine. So in 5, can you tell me 0 and then 5? Okay, then 10. Any more elements? Any possibility? And in 3, 0, 3, 6, and then 9, and then 12. Fine. Any more possibility? And this is Z15 itself. Okay. And you know that order of subgroup divide the order of group. You can see the order of this one is 3. This is the order of this is 5. If you are thinking that there can be one more element, 6 element, so this is not possible because 6 doesn't divide 15. Okay. This is true in case of the cyclic group. General result we will see in next other classes. Panji is non-cyclic, so in that case the result become more interesting, because not corresponding to each divisor we don't have a subgroup, so that we will see. But in case of a cyclic group, if k divides order of group, then we are going to certainly have a subgroup of this order. So this you should remember this one. Okay, fine. So let us see, the order of this one is 1, and then we have 3, then we have 5, then we have 15. So order of the group, subgroups are there. Okay, let us move further. So we have a theorem number 4.4. So this says that if D is a positive divisor of N, and suppose D is a cyclic group of order N, and D is a divisor of N, that is D divides N, then the number of elements of order D, then number of elements of order D, this particular order, just like you can see here, the divisor of 15 are 1, 3, 5 and 15. So one question is that how many elements are in Z15 which are having order 3, which are having 5, order 5, and the number of elements having order 15. So this is the question. Okay. So this is theorem 4.4 answers this question, that the number of elements of order d is essentially, they are talking about the cyclic group, you should know. So fine, d in G is phi n, okay, of order d in a cyclic group of order n is phi d. So this is conclusion of this theorem. So let us prove this one. So what we need to have at one divisor. Let us assume that one. So let d divides n, and n is nothing but order of g. Fine. So certainly g is going to be a cyclic group of order n. If there is some generator, okay. So or let me write precisely. Let g be a cyclic group. And order of g equals to n. Let us assume that d divides n, okay, fine. So then there is a subgroup of G of order D. Are you getting from here? We are concluding this one. This is a conclusion of theorem, the first theorem we were discussing. Fine. No, this one. Yeah, from this here, okay, this one from here, okay. So if order of this is n, then the order of any subgroup of A, this divides n, and then for each positive divisor, that is the first part, okay, there is a subgroup of order k, exactly one subgroup of order k. So k was dividing, k is a divisor of n, and then we are having a subgroup of order k, namely this one, okay, fine. So there is a subgroup of g of order d, and let that subgroup be H, and this is assume that this is generated by A. So therefore A should be of order D. Fine. So because there is a subgroup of order D, then there must be some, because this is subgroup of a cyclic group, so there must be some element, okay, element in H, so that it has order D and generates H. Fine. So what are other generators? Thing is that, fine, what are the other generators? Or else we can say that we need to count the number of elements of order D in that group. Fine, the number of elements of order D. We have one element here, but we need to find that what other elements are there in G which are having order D. That if D divides N, it doesn't mean that there is only one element of order D. There may be so many elements of that particular order. So this need to be counted. Theek, fine. So how come we can know? Okay. One thing is that if H is a subgroup of G and A is a generator and A has order D, so other elements which are of order D will also generate H. Fine. Is it okay? Because H is a cyclic subgroup of G and A is generated with order D. So other elements which are having order D will also be a generator of H. Fine. So in that case, for example, if we talk about that, let other, or we can assume like this, let A to the power K, fine, A to the power K generates H, fine. So what we need to find? We need to find whether A to the power K has order D or not. And if it has order D, what is the condition? Fine. So this will be generator of H. Then the order of A to the power K must be equals to, do you remember what is the formula? Order of A divided by greatest common divisor of order of A and K. Fine. Is it okay? So what we have, order of A is D and order of, this is a order of A is D and this is K. Fine. So can you tell me, please, could you please tell me, if we are talking about order of K, A to the power K, that we are having a greatest common D divided by greatest common divisor of D and K. Could you tell me when this is equals to D? Because if at all this is a generator of H and H has order D and is cyclic generated by A, so the other generators of H should be or must be having the same order as A was having. So the order of this is equals to D if and only if. What should I write? Please tell me.
D and K and co-prime.
Very good. Please note down one point for this one. That is, D and K has to be relatively prime. Fine. And then you know that once we come across this kind of thing, so we need to refer what? We need to refer Euler phi formula. Fine. This is a Euler, right? We write like this, but the pronunciation is like this, Euler. Okay, so you should remember. So Euler phi function. So A to the power K is equals to D if and only if greatest common divisor of D and K is 1. So very interesting result, you know. Fine. So how many K are possible here? How many K are possible? It means that we are counting only those K which are relatively prime to D. And of course, relatively prime to D. And you know that what will be there? What will be in numbers? P of D, fine. You remember like this, you know. Then you will be counting all those functions or those numbers which are positive and less than n and relatively prime to n. So here also, okay. So we are counting all those numbers less than D and relatively prime to D. Fine. So they are how many numbers? 5D. Fine. So it means that 5D are the powers here. You know, K may take these many values. How many values? 5T. So how many generators are there? How many generators? Or in one sense, how many elements of order D are there? Fine. So there are exactly 5D number of elements of order D in G. Fine. Let us see some example, a simple example. I'm taking the simple example to demonstrate this one. Let us take maybe Z6, okay, Z6, and addition modulo n, fine. So divisors, okay, divisors of 6, 1, 2, 3, and 6, 4 divisors are there. And of course, this is cyclic group, and Z6 is generated by, we have at least one generator generated by 1, fine, okay. So what it says, this theorem says, if D is a divisor of N, okay, so we need to choose first D, and then the number of elements of that particular order of in that group is phi of D, fine. So D is a positive divisor, so number of elements of order D, that is for each divisor, it has an element of that particular order. One divide 6, so it has or we can write here order, okay, fine, order and elements, what are the elements and their number of elements, okay, number of elements. So what possibility we have elements in this group of 1 order, 2 order, 3 order and 6 order, okay, fine. What are the elements in Z6 of that particular order? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. You can write 1 order ka kaun sa element hai? 0 hai. 2 order ke kaun kaun se hai? 3. Fine, 3 plus 3, 6, all right. So, kaun sa element hai? 3. Aur kaun sa element hai? Koi aur element hai? 2 order ka? Nahi hai. 3 order ke kaun se hai? 2 plus 2 plus 2, 6. That is 2 element hai, ye element hai, ye 3 order ka hai. Fine. And 2 and 4 are inverse of each other. So, iska bhi order same hoga, 2 and 4. 6 order ka kaun sa element hai? Ek element hai. So, total elements kitne hoga? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. एक एलिमेंट और बच रहा है कहीं? 5. 5 किस ऑर्डर का है? हेलो हेलो
यस सर
5 का ऑर्डर क्या होगा बेटा? n टाइम्स 5 इक्वल्स टू 0. एट मिनिमम क्या यहां पे मल्टीप्लाई करें या फिर ऐड करें 5 को कितने टाइम्स? 2 टाइम्स करेंगे तो नहीं 0 आएगा, 3 टाइम्स करेंगे तो भी नहीं आएगा ना, 4 टाइम्स करेंगे तो नहीं,
6 टाइम्स करना पड़ेगा सर.
5 टाइम्स भी नहीं, 6 टाइम्स ना. सो 6 ऑड 1 और 5 बिकॉज़ दे आर इनवर्स ऑफ ईच अदर, सो 5 भी होंगे. तो टोटल नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स 6 हो गए ना, और यही 6 नंबर एलिमेंट्स है यहां पे, ये ऑर्डर है. सो नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स ऑफ ऑर्डर 1 कितना होगा बेटा? 51. नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स ऑफ ऑर्डर 2 कितने होंगे? Phi 2 and then phi of 3 and then phi of 6. ठीक है ना, phi of 1 1 होता है. 2 के कितने पॉजिटिव डिवाइजर्स हैं जो लेस देन 2 हो?
सिर्फ 1 है.
phi of n की डेफिनेशन जान रहे हो ना आप? डिवाइजर्स which are relatively prime to n and less than n, fine. And similarly, 1 or 3 ke kaun kaun se divisor hai? Hello. Phi of 2 aapka 2 hoga, aap dekhiyega, theek hai na. relatively prime to this one and less than this one. Relatively prime to this one, yeah. And then you have 6, and then you have 3K divisors. Kaun kaun se honge? 1 and 3. So ye bhi ho jayega 2. Theek hai. So just a minute. Number of elements. No, 5 2 ye 1 hone ja raha hai. 5 2 1 hoga. I'm just missing something. Actually, we are not talking about divisors here. Number of elements less than that one are relatively prime to that one. ठीक है? तो 3 के जो relatively prime होंगे 1 और 2 होगा, है ना? Relatively prime होंगे तो 1 और 2 होगा, तो total number 2 हो जाएगा. 2 के relatively prime less than वो कितना होगा? 1 होगा, है ना? और 6 से less और relatively prime to 6 कितने होंगे? 1 हो जाएगा, 2 नहीं होगा, 3 नहीं होगा, 4 नहीं होगा, 5 हो जाएगा, है ना? तो कितने हो जाएंगे? 2 हो जाएंगे. पक्का? Are you getting my point? Hello? 5n means that is all those k which are relatively prime to n. ठीक है? And k should be less than n and greater than or equals to 1. Fine? हमें ये divisor नहीं, divisor तो हमने यहाँ पे देखा, तो उसमें confusion हो रहा था. Anyway. So, आप देखेंगे वन ऑर्डर के कितने एलिमेंट? 1 है, एक एलिमेंट है ना. 2 ऑर्डर के कितने एलिमेंट्स है? 1 है. कितने एलिमेंट? 3 है. 3 ऑर्डर के कितने? 2 है. यहाँ पे 2 एलिमेंट दिख रहे हैं. यहाँ पे 6 ऑर्डर के कितने हैं? 2 एलिमेंट्स हैं. तो 2 यहाँ पे दिख रहे हैं. सो ये स्ट्रक्चर आपको समझ में आ गया? ओके, पक्का? कोई दिक्कत नहीं? चलिए बस आई विल टेक 5 मिनट्स मोर. There is a result, there is a corollary, it's very simple. आप इसको अपने से कीजिएगा, ठीक ना? Proof है इसमें, सब कुछ explain किया हुआ है, इसलिए मैंने इसमें रख दिया है. And you can read it. And if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Fine? Very clear and crystal proof is there.
Okay, sir.
I think there is no problem. There is no need of explanation. But still, if you are having, I can elaborate. Okay, so here we have some lattice. We say the lattice of Z30, that is they are going to talk about subgroups of Z30. Fine. So here, if you see, we have subgroups of Z30. So generated by 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, 15, and 30. So total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we have 8 subgroups of Z30. So in Z30, they are making hierarchy. That is, the group generated by 1 is a bigger one. Fine. It contains all subgroups. And 2 and 5, they are not contained in each other as a subset. Of course, some elements may be common. Okay. Just like in 5, we have 0 and 5. Fine. And then we have 10. That is multiple of this one. 15, and then we have 20, then we have 25. Okay, so these many elements. In 2, we have all multiple of 2, that is a 0, and then 2, 4, something like this, and then up to 28 we are having. Of course, there may be some, there may be 10 also, there may be 20 also, but none of them is entirely contained in other. Of course, some elements may be common. Okay. So 2 and 5 are subgroups of 1, and then 3 is also subgroup of this one. That is, this is the group. This group is nothing but Z30. Z30 has so many subgroups. Okay, 0 doesn't have any subgroup. Okay, it doesn't have any subgroup. And this 6, the group generated by 6 and 15. Okay. They have one subgroup, that is the group generated by the 0. Okay, 1 has so many subgroups. You see 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 subgroups. Okay, so this is the hierarchy. One can 3 and 10, they are not connected. 3 and 10, the group generated by 3 and 10, they are not connected in any way. Of course, they are subgroups of 1. So similarly, you can make the subgroups of Z15 also, fine. So you may be keeping like this, the group generated by one, and then you said how many? I think 1, 2, 3, 6, I think. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 6. So group generated by two, and then the group generated by this one, and then a group generated by, I think, what is there? 6 is nothing but 0, you know, 6 is nothing but 0. So here we have 6 also, that is 0 element. Okay, so something like this, you can see whether there is a, of course 2 and 3 are not going to be contained indirectly in each other, some elements may be common. Okay, so that is the thing, fine. So similarly, you can make a lattice of other subgroups of a cyclic group, fine. Okay, so with this, we are done with the properties and classification of cyclic group.